Hello and welcome to yet another tutorial by Davies Media Design. My name is Michael Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be going over GIMP in 10 minutes, what beginners want to know. If you're looking for a more in-depth look at GIMP, I recommend watching my 2-hour GIMP 2.10 basics video, which is on our channel, and of course, I'll link that in the description. But let's get started. So GIMP, which stands for GNU Image Manipulation Program, is a powerful raster-based open source software that is developed by a small community of developers. This software, which is primarily used for photo editing, but is also used for graphic design, is available completely for free at gimp.org. Despite having a relatively small team of part-time developers behind it, GIMP is actually a very powerful program, and it rivals and is most similar to Photoshop, which is another raster-based program. The main difference, of course, between GIMP and Photoshop is that Photoshop can cost between $10 and $60 a month if you have the subscription program, whereas GIMP, of course, is absolutely free. So GIMP rivaling Photoshop has become even more true over the past year because it recently updated GIMP with its first major update in over 6 years, and that was GIMP version 2.10. At the time of this tutorial, GIMP 2.10.6 is the most up-to-date version of GIMP, and the GIMP team says that GIMP 3.0, which may completely change the game and possibly break the internet, is supposed to come out either later this year or in early 2019. So let's get a little bit into how to use GIMP, and as I mentioned earlier in this tutorial, I do have a full 2-hour length video that shows a little bit more in-depth look at the GIMP basics. Once you've installed GIMP on your Windows, Mac, or Linux computer, open it up and go to File New to create a new composition. Here you can set your new image dimensions or expand your options to set things like the resolution, precision, or background color of your image. Click OK to create the new image. The GIMP layout looks complex at first, but can be understood as 5 main sections. The toolbox contains all your tools. The tool options contains the settings for the tool you have selected. The canvas will display your image or composition. The Layers, Channels, Paths, Undo panel will display the items mentioned in its name, displaying the Layers panel first by default. And the Brushes, Patterns, and Gradient panel will display those items mentioned in its name. Starting with the toolbox, GIMP's tools are broken up into 4 main groups: Selection Tools, Paint Tools, Transform Tools, and Other Tools. Selection tools allow you to select an area of your image using various methods, and you can then make edits to those isolated items that are in the selection area you specified. Paint tools allow you to freely draw or paint on your image or composition, and you can use colors, patterns, or transparency to paint or erase with these tools. Transform tools allow you to transform an active layer, selection area, or path. For example, you can scale something up or down, or change its perspective, among other transformations. The other tools allow you to perform various functions such as zooming in and out of your image, selecting your foreground and background colors, drawing curves, and adding text. Above the 5 main areas of GIMP is your main menu. This menu allows you to access everything within GIMP. However, if you want to look for something a little bit more quickly, simply hit the / key on your keyboard to bring up the search feature and type what you're looking for. You can then click on the item to jump to it if it's a file, or use it on your composition, for example, if it's an effect. Going back to our main menu, I'll highlight the 2 most important menu items in my opinion. These are the Colors menu and the Filters menu. The Colors menu allows you to access important image adjustment tools. These tools are great for photo editing and include common image adjustment tools such as color balance, hue saturation, shadows highlights, brightness contrast, levels, and curves, to name just a few. I use these image adjustment tools often throughout my tutorials and in my GIMP photo editing course. Unfortunately, unlike Photoshop, GIMP currently does not contain adjustment layers, which means your image adjustments are typically made directly on your image layer. However, the GIMP team says they have made steps towards making this feature available in the near future. Lower in the Colors menu are some auto adjustments and adjustment filters that aim to speed up your photo editing, though I do not typically recommend using these except in specific cases. The Filters menu contains many important filters that you can use throughout your compositions. Some of them will apply to the entire image, while others will only apply to a selected layer or are overlaid on top of your compositions as a separate layer. The most popular filters, in my experience, include Blur Gaussian Blur, enhance, sharpen, unsharp mask, light and shadow, and there's a few popular filters in here, including drop shadow, long shadow, and vignette, map, little planet, and animation playback when working with animated GIFs. So these are just a few of many useful filters found in this program. Heading back to the layers panel, note that everything you do in GIMP will be on a layer. When creating a new composition like we did earlier, you're going to start with a background layer. You could then add or remove layers as you work, with layers containing things like text, transparency, graphics, or images. You can also change the modes of layers, which allow the layers to blend and interact with other layers in the layers panel. I have an entire tutorial dedicated to layers, which I recommend you watch to learn more about the layers concept. You can open new images into GIMP by going to File Open, which will open images into their own new composition. Simply navigate to the folder where your file is located and click on the file to select that file. Click the Open button to open the file into GIMP. You can also go to File, Open as Layers to open your file into your current composition as a layer. You can also go to File, Open Recent to open an image file you recently opened into GIMP. You can save your work at any time by going to File, Save, or File, Save As using the native .xcf file format in GIMP. I'll rename my file, then select the location where I want to save it. Saving your file as a .xcf will preserve the layers in your composition, allowing you to come back and work on your project at a later time. You can also export files to other common file formats by going to File, Export As. Here you can click the Select File Type by Extension dropdown and choose from file types such as GIF, JPEG, PSD, or PDF. I'll select JPEG as my file type since this is the most common file type to export images to. You'll see the file extension after the name of my file will automatically update to .jpeg once I click this. I'll then click Export to export my file, select the quality of my JPEG, and we'll click Export again. I'll delete my active layer that contains the image we opened as a layer into the composition by clicking the Delete This Layer icon. So that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you guys liked it. If you did, please subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/DaviesMediaDesign. On there, you could check out our 2-hour GIMP 2.10 basics video. You can also visit our website at daviesmediadesign.com. You can enroll in our GIMP photo editing course from beginner to pro photo retoucher on Udemy. And you can support our channel and help us grow by becoming a patron on Patreon. And I'll include a link to those items as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.